I used to draw houses and make the plans for the houses and the buildings and then put Gerson Estates on it. Also now I run my family's real estate. I am the landlord. In the midst of that, I wanted to be a stand-up comedian, and Shelley Berman was my hero. So I used to know all the Shelley Berman routines. All nows are different and the world's unfolding, but all that has passed is necessary now. Through the choice of inevitability and the application of pure reason, we snag the artifacts of subjectivity and learn the methods of coincidence. I'm not always the best interpreter of my work. And I don't think artists generally are the best interpreters of their work, because that's not what they're... The work is what they do, not the interpretation of it. It's a, you know, juxtaposition of odd elements. With me as a child, was I liked anything that was the biggest. And anything that was big, I liked it. So tallest building, you know, I always knew which were the tallest buildings. And dinosaurs, you know, were huge. So I liked big, giant dinosaurs. But my earliest thing was to be a paleontologist. That was my first ambition. Here I am with a show about dinosaurs. I also used cardboard from my father's store. I was gonna be the richest man in the world. And so I used to draw what I was gonna own. So, but I started drawing very young. I used to draw on shelf paper. My mother would get shelf paper and I would roll it out and draw it and then roll it up. Now I would give anything to be able to go back and spend some time at my father's store while it's open. And my father's store was here. My uncle's store was here. Many of their friends' businesses were here. The synagogue we went to was up the street. My great-grandmother lived on Barone Street, not far away. My Aunt Rose. My mother was at the store until the end, and I think we closed in 1989. My father was on Dryad Street from the 30s on. And one of the things I used to do all the time was sneak off and go read comics at Lala's drugstore over here. I think the framing devices in comic books affected my prints that I did in graduate school and a few years after, of these small multi-plate prints. I have dreams about my father's store and Dryad Street, and almost invariably the store has been renewed. I don't think my work really, at least on a conscious level, refers to my dreams. I don't try to remember my dreams and then paint what I've seen, like some of the surrealists did. The aesthetic of reason, the wisdom to fit in. I divide the indivisible and scribble in a lapidary style. My work now has softer edges. It still has that kind of edgy humor and dark side to it. There's always a thorn in the flower. There's, you know, a snake in the grass. My flowers look like they could eat the bees that pollinate them, by and large. They're much fleshier than real flowers. I tend to fill up spaces, even when I was a printmaker. My inclination is not to leave any empty space. I'm not a minimalist. I try to fill the back space as much as the front space. I try to, well, sometimes I leave an opening so that you can see into the distance, so that you know that everything isn't front forward. But a lot of my jungle scenes are front forward, and I think that partly is from living in New Orleans, where everything is at eye level and you never have vistas unless you go up on a tall building. When I stopped doing etchings, I started just doing these very loose drawings. And pretty soon I developed this character with very long, loose limbs, a sausage kind of body, and this big mouth of teeth that crosses the face. It's very cartoon looking and childlike. And I did hundreds and hundreds of drawings with this figure that I call my goofy guy. Plants started springing up in his world, and they had these thicker stems. The flowers were a little more, the larger petals. They were just a little bit out of joint, a little bit larger than normal. I have a show up right now, installation at the Universal Furniture for Prospect One of little figures that I've done over the years made out of kneaded erasers that I've molded like clay. And this particular grouping is 300 people wearing coats, and they just sort of stood up on a runway.
My next show is at Lemieux Galleries in the Warehouse District, and it's called Dinosaurs, Aliens, and UFOs.
And that initiated from thinking about UFOs or aliens coming to the planet 200 million years ago and seeing dinosaurs and seeing the planet as it was then and leaving and not realizing what would happen later. My UFOs are very stylized, also rounded, almost like very spare vegetation with spheres and tubes, a series of tubes, and not the flying saucer kind of things in general. If you're a good artist, I think your meanings are ambiguous and point to things. Great art, I think, doesn't give answers, it poses questions. Whether or not there's art is of any relevance to aliens from other planets, or whether or not they have a sense of humor, I think is an intriguing question. It would be really a wonderful experience to just be able to ask any question and find out if there is any universal way of looking at things across the universe. If every planet had, every civilization had stand-up comics and Shelley Berman, I think it would be a positive sign for the universe. Thank you.